Greetings, this is another video review by the flashlight reviewer known as selfbuilt. Today I'm looking at the V20C from Sunwayman. Sunwayman's been around for a little while now. Actually, I think they've been around for some time as an OEM manufacturer of lights, but they've been making lights under their own name for the past year or so. One thing that always distinguishes Sunwayman lights is the quality of the anodizing. Very smooth, high quality, dark gray natural finish. I always find it to be one of the most attractive anodizings I've seen. Usually flawless, no chips, no damage, very smooth deposition of the anodizing. Labels are usually a very clear, bright white, as you see here. There may be a few more than usual in this light, but that has to do with a bit with how it functions. I'll get to that in a moment. Maybe a few comments about build first. Stainless steel bezel ring. You can see there's a lightly textured, somewhat orange peel reflector in there. Anyway, see if we get that to focus. Not heavily textured, but enough to smooth out the rings. So you should have a fairly good beam at the end. I actually like a little more crenellation on the bezel, so if you turn the light on and put it upside down, you can actually tell that it's on. It's not a big deal, but it's a nice feature I like. And of course, some people like a more aggressive raised tactical bezel. I just find a slight crenellation is okay. If we open up the tail cap, you'll see there's an 18650 in it. And I'll see if we can get that to focus for you. You have nicely square cut or machinist threads. They're fully anodized per tail cap lockout. You can see there's anodizing on the inside of the tail cap clicky as well. Screw thread action is very smooth, no grit, very nice, pleasure to hold and use. There's a bit of knurling on the tail cap and a bit of knurling on the grip ring, the control ring here in the head. Not much on the body, although there is a grip ring. Still, overall, hand feel is good. It's not too smooth. Maybe, you know, some people might like a little bit more knurling on the body. There's a few fluted ridges that help a bit with grip. But one thing that I really like is that the control ring has knurling on it. One thing I find, and even on some of the early Sunwayman lights, there's not enough to differentiate the ring. In the dark, it can be kind of hard to figure out where you're supposed to be turning. More defined knurling helps for that. The other thing that they've done on this light is you can see they've put very definite labels on the grip ring and on the body around it. So you can probably see here, right on the grip ring, there's a flat area with an arrowhead. It's currently pointing to off, which is a standby mode for the light. Then there is this raised kind of triangle area, which sort of shows you output is increasing. Up to a certain point, that's max. Then a little bit later, there's a bright flashing strobe icon. The light has definite detents, so maybe we'll put it on here. So you see there's no light at first when it's set to off. And as you, of course, increase the ring, there we go, light comes on, light increases in output, up to max, and then strobe. So do that again, just turn it down, all the way down to off. One thing you might notice as well, I'll do that again with it clicked off. If you listen carefully, you should be able to hear the clicks at each of the modes. So as you can see, there's an audible click at each detent. So there's a very firm position where you're off, another firm position when you're at max, another firm position at strobe. So it's kind of helpful to know where you are at any given time. The other thing you probably noticed by looking at the output, turn that back on. Start down at low. See, there's a very low initial output. Slowly ramps up. And you can see it gets fairly bright. One thing about the ramp, though, is it's pretty much visually linear. Now, it may not seem that way on the camera. Seems like it just sort of takes off at a certain point. But the reason for that is that it gives you a lot of control at the low levels. So you can adjust the ring and get quite a exquisite control. And you can see right above the min, right above the off, there's a very nice low-level output. And yeah, seeing how low I can get this to go. Bit of a flash when it first comes on. But a very nice low output level, which is something I quite like on a light. And a lot of control over how bright that gets at the lower level. One other problem with a lot of the early control rings is they used basically a circuit linear control, which means that the output increases linearly as you turn the ring. The problem is that our brains and visual systems don't interpret light in a linear way like that. Most people tend to think of it as a logarithmic ramp is what actually works better for our ability to perceive light. although modern research for the last several decades suggests it's actually a power relationship, and in the case of a non-point source of light, like a flashlight beam, it's more like a cube root power relationship, not a direct logarithmic one. Although the principle is still the same, we don't see light outputs in a visually linear way as you increase output. This is why 200 lumens doesn't look twice as bright as 100 lumens. And so if you had a perfectly linear ramp for output, it doesn't look very linear to us. So on a bunch of the newer lights, you find that they do this kind of ramp instead, which is probably more of a logarithmic ramp, which has the benefit of looking more visually linear. Maybe not entirely so, depending on your perspective. And of course, the camera doesn't capture it very well. But in an actual practical use, I find this sort of ramp very useful. It's much easier to see what you're doing when you have more exquisite control over what exactly output you're taking. An interesting feature here I noticed too, when you first turn on the light, it sort of ramps you up to your output level. It doesn't just go to it on max. That's kind of an interesting feature. Anyway, nice little light. I like the firm detents as well, so you don't accidentally move into strobe mode. You know you're there if you want it. You can get it to come on in that mode if you like. So if you like that kind of tactical feature, you can have it come on in max. You can have it come on anywhere, and you can kind of estimate. The only thing that maybe that's not quite ideal for me is the degree of the turn. That's only about a 90-degree angle that the ring turns. I generally prefer a little bit more. Some people like it like this. I think probably somewhere around half the diameter of the turn, like 180 degrees, is probably a good range. But a quarter of the turn, you know, is at least acceptable, especially when you have a non-linear ramp, or I should say a visually linear ramp that allows you to have a better output control to match what you see by eye. So that's the overall build of the light. You can see more details on the runtime, beam shots, and various other aspects of the light in my detailed review, which you will find off my master review list at flashlightreviews.ca, or you can go directly to Candle Power forums and look in the review forum where you'll find the reviews by the user self-built. But again, if you go to flashlightreviews.ca, you'll see the master list of all my reviews with direct links to the Candle Power forum site. Anyway, hope you found that overview useful. Thank you for your time.